Hey guys, how are you doing? This is Queen here live coming from Milwaukee Airport and the DNC2020 right here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. But a lot of the issues today, but we're chatting it again. We got one more day of the tonight on Wednesday the 19th, as well as Thursday on the 20th. We have two more days left of the Democratic National Convention here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, 6 hours outside of Chicago. Ooh. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and go through a couple quick things about COVID research. Originally, the DNC, Democratic National Convention, was supposed to have about 50,000 people. We're supposed to be here in Milwaukee this week to help support our potential leader for our Democratic National Convention. But as you know, due to COVID regulations, we lost a lot of senators, as well as we lost a lot of other people, senators and their senators, congressmen, representatives, and their staffs from coming here to Milwaukee, and they were advised not to be here due to COVID regulations. You're fine, don't worry. And so pretty much what is going to happen is that it went from 50,000 to 10,000 to 1,500, and now there's about maybe under 300 people here, or maybe more or less here in Milwaukee tonight at the Milwaukee Convention Center here, live in of course, north of Chicago, about 6-7 hours north of Chicago here at the Milwaukee Airport. So I'm here live, I'm here on YouTube, just being able to relate to you guys as well as to my COVID research. Pretty much letting you guys know that the DNC is doing a good job. They do need to acquire more clinical and medical staff, as well as more COVID-19 testing staff to help facilitate the need. Even if there's 20 people here, even if there's 100 people here, even if there's 200 people here, they still need to help facilitate the need for COVID testing here at the in Milwaukee. Okay. So pretty much they need more healthcare staff, as well as they do need security. They do have the FBI and the secret police here, but secret services here, but they do need more outside security, local and outside security, to be posted around the perimeters of the convention center, which they're having a lot of right now. So they do need additional peace officers and security officials to help facilitate the event tonight on Wednesday, as well as Thursday here in Milwaukee. Okay. All right. So I'm here, and we will go ahead and just talk about a couple more things just to help with COVID right now. I'm the only one here in Milwaukee by myself. Be sleeping here in the airport tonight. Yay. So we have to get used to it. Okay. A couple more things. They are doing great. Great with helping facilitate all the people here. Security clearances are going great. As well as pretty much getting everybody here into the facility of the convention center and getting them out back to their designated hostels and their designated hotels. Great. No major issues with illnesses or emergency room visits so far that I've noticed or that I've heard of. So I'm pretty much in the closest to hospital facility here at Milwaukee, downtown Milwaukee, is Advocate Mount Sinai Hospital. Advocate Aurora Health Mount Sinai is a hospital here in Milwaukee. So pretty much they're a beautiful hospital facility. A beautiful hospital facility and staff here in Milwaukee, Advocate Mount Sinai, as well as St. Mary's. St. Mary's is also a good hospital and facility staff here in Milwaukee to help facilitate the DNC. Okay, Milwaukee police, really nice police, a force to work with, knowledgeable, pleasant. If you want them to be pleasant to you, they'll be pleasant back to you as well. So Milwaukee police, thank you so much, as well as for Advocate Aurora Health here here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. So thank you both of you two sites for helping me to make sure that I was able to communicate with you guys, as well as communicate with the DNC and other people who pretty much needed your services. Even if the contract was open or closed, I still was able to help facilitate the needs and the services. Just get out the word. Please send medical staff to this convention center, as well as please check with your local police. Even if they got off the job, or even if Milwaukee police was let off the job, or they're back on the job, they still need to be around the vicinity, because this is the area, and also the DNC also has to pay tax dollars to the city of Milwaukee and Wisconsin State Police too. So there needs to be more local police enforcement, as well as Wisconsin State Police just in case for my antlers and I just finish off the convention, make sure. If they can send off one or two officials, they would have been great. Alright, other than that, COVID is going pretty good. Not a lot of coughs here in Milwaukee. Fevers, I'm not really sure about that. I have to check the statistics from Advocate Award Health Hospitals. Normally, it's a lot of babies. A lot of babies here in Milwaukee, a lot of babies, 6 months old, 1 year old, as well as pretty much just keep your face mask on. These are provided by the Tourism Board here in Milwaukee. Tourism Board, great. So this is a great facility to help service. Give some great face masks as well. Okay. So thank you to Milwaukee Tourism Board and other people involved to help facilitate. Thank you to the Hilton Hotels as well as to the Marriott here in Milwaukee, the Hilton here in Milwaukee, as well as the Super 8 and other hotels were able to help facilitate, and the restaurants, the local restaurants and pubs that were actually able to help facilitate the DNC Convention Center as well. See, two young girls walking by, that's great, they look great. Okay, all right, so some other people that pretty much I want to give a thank you out to. I want to give a thanks to, of course, Advocate Award Health Hospital and St. Mary's Hospital. Even though I wasn't able actually to meet and greet with St. Mary's Hospital, I'd still like to thank them for providing their services as well. I'm going to go ahead and give a shout out to a couple of media people, PBS, Milwaukee, Telemundo Milwaukee, ABC, NBC, and CBS Milwaukee for allowing me to speak with them quickly, and I was able to meet about 3 or 4 other people sitting out here to the DNC, let them know that they're available. I didn't really do any interviews, but I still was able to see if they needed any kind of assistance. So thank you to NBC, CBS, and ABC Milwaukee for letting me know that that they're okay, their staff was good, their team people were good. They came in, they did a shot, and they left. Air was good. No major issues to exposure or anything like that. So pretty much they were not able, the TV media people did still have the same issue that I had, which was getting on the premises as well as getting access inside the hotels as pretty much as well as getting access to registrants. So pretty much what the local TV media had a little bit of issues, but they still were able to get interviews inside the convention center, but you still had to be a registered media person approved by the DNC beforehand. And instead of being a local team reporter, you had to be a national, nationwide TV station approved by the DNC in order to get any kind of service. Okay, so pretty much the locals here, local TV stations here in Milwaukee, were pretty much out and about doing a job great. So thank you to local TV and media. I didn't see any radio here in Milwaukee. I did not see any radio. I may have saw about 1 or 2. But thank you to TV and radio and other media involved here in Milwaukee. We're actually able to help facilitate the DNC convention here in Milwaukee. As well as a lot of other resources, I would like to thank the staff here at the DNC. I tried to work with them, I didn't really find the faces, but unfortunately we did not have that connectivity. We did not have that connect relationship on the premises. So unfortunately, they had a lot of registration at one of the hotels. They had a whole bunch of registration at the hotels, not really at the convention center, but at the hotels, which is great, but I still was not able to actually get there and help support services due to not being available, as well as to not being able to see what kind of resources they needed, which they still needed service, they still needed medical help, and they still needed more security staff on the premises. So, I was able to pretty much go in the community and just pretty much hang around, which is what a lot of media people do. They come in and then they leave. That's pretty much about it. All right. So thank you to the DNC nationwide, the DNC national in Washington, D.C. Thank you to DNC. Not just the convention. There's a difference between the convention and the difference between the DNC national headquarters. So I'm going to go ahead and give a shout out to the DNC national headquarters in Washington, D.C., their offices and their staff in Washington, D.C., as well as a DNC office here in Milwaukee, which I know they're out and about doing candidacy and paper getting supporters ready for a convention staff, for staff, as well as other political reporters people getting people pretty much ready and prepared for their statewide elections here in Wisconsin, as well as for the presidential election. So give a shout out to the DNC office in Washington, D.C., as well as DNC headquarters in Washington, D.C., as well as DNC office here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and Chicago, Illinois. So thank you guys. Shout out again. I want to thank MKE Milwaukee Airport for just helping me to facilitate American Airlines for being really cordial with me and helping to facilitate me with my services and my needs, as well as people getting out there seeing if there are any kind of additional support services I need here to assist me and my medical supplies and equipment. All my medical supplies and equipment. I want to thank the MKE airport right here in Milwaukee, as well as I'm going to thank American Airlines and Southwest. American Airlines here and American Eagle here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, for being able to allow me to facilitate my private equipment, even though it wasn't needed at this convention. I'm sure it will be needed next week in the Cuban convention in Charlotte, as well as in DC for the National March of Washington. So thank you again to the MKE Milwaukee airport, as well as American Airlines as staff here in Milwaukee, in Boston, and the American Airlines staff in Boston is really cordial, as well as the American Airlines staff here in Milwaukee is really, really nice. I would like to thank the Cuban City Hostel for allowing me to get my first day staying there. Really, a really decent price. Thank you to the Cuban City Hostel. Thank you to the Cuban City Hostel, as well as a lot of other people involved, the local residents here in Milwaukee, downtown Milwaukee, local city residents, as well as the University of Wisconsin at Milwaukee. Thank you to the University of Wisconsin and Milwaukee for your services and assistance. Really appreciate you here, as well as thank you to the USA Operations Office here in Milwaukee, as well as the Renaissance Bookstore here at the MKE Airport and the USO Airport, USO United States Operations, USO Armed Force Services Office here in Boston, as well as here in Milwaukee. Thank you so much, guys, for your assistance and services. Of course, a couple people in Boston, Mayor Marty Walsh in Boston, thank you for your services, as well as to Governor Charlie Baker, thank you for your services, and Lieutenant Governor Karen Pulido, thank you for your services there in Boston, as well as senior and staff who are down here to the DNC convention, thank you to you as well as I cannot forget my New York people, the whole entire legislation, the city of Albany, representatives and the assembly people, the New York State Senate and the New York Assembly, New York State Assembly and New York State Senate. Thank you to the entire New York State Senate and New York Assembly, New York Assembly Council. Everybody in Albany, downtown Albany, the New York State Capitol, as well as everybody in New York City. Mayor Bill de Blasio, thank you so much for knowing Mayor Bill de Blasio, as well as NYPD. Thank you so much, NYPD. Every time I've come to New York City, I've had a great relationship with the NYPD. So thank you so much, NYPD, as well as Occupy City Hall. We still got a lot of work to do. Black Lives Matter in New York, we still got a lot of work to do, as well as a couple other senators. Senator Kevin Parker, thank you for your relationship, as well as to Queens Representative Brooklyn Senator Kevin Parker. Representative Queen Assemblywoman Vivian Cook, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who's in the Bronx. Thank you, our Miss Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who's part of the Fabulous Four, a wonderful, wonderful group of Fabulous Four women in New York, California, Boston, as well as to Boston Senator, can't forget her name, she's gonna kill me. Ayanla Pressley, Senator Ayanla Pressley in Boston, part of the Fabulous Group of Fabulous Four Women, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Ayanla Pressley, Miss Amar, and then we cannot forget the squad, they call the squad of the Fabulous Four. Wonderful women that have participated in elections this year. Ms. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez in New York, Ian Omar in Minnesota, Ayanna Presley in Boston, and Ms. Rashida Khalid in Michigan. Wonderful women, wonderful women. Thank you guys for your participation. Letting know that women are still empowered and in control of the decision process. Okay, there's a lot more we have to do and be involved in here. Again, thank you to MPA Airport as well as American Airlines for helping to facilitate me. During this convention, I have about 24 more hours left in this city, and then I will be back in Boston. From Boston, I will be going towards Charlotte for 2-3 days. Charlotte, I'll be going to Washington, D.C. to help participate with the National Market in Washington. Get a table at First Gate 10. It will be organized in Washington, D.C. for the National Market in Washington, organized by Reverend. Honorable Al Sharpton. So there's a lot more events are happening. I'll probably be kicked out a couple more times, have to get used to it. It is live, you have to be involved in the global process as well as pretty much get things in order to take care of. And then also, thank you for the beautiful city of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great, lovely, clean city. Clean, very clean facilities everywhere I've been. Everything's pretty much been very clean. The water here is great. Rivers everywhere, water everywhere. Great school system. University of Wisconsin is a great school system. And the young people are very vibrant here, as well as on the neighborhoods. So because, you know, depends if you want to do a short walk or a long walk. So thank you to the city and the citizens of Milwaukee for helping to facilitate me and battle first aid responder services here at the Democratic National Convention. Okay. Other than that, I'm just getting ready to be doing a couple of reports. Again, COVID exposure, you have to be very careful, take care of yourself. Drink plenty of fluids. Be sure to drink plenty of fluids, as well as be sure to check your temperature every single day. Make sure you get that temperature check every single day. Go out, have a nice walk, fresh air. Let people know, breathe the city, exercise, ride a bike, riding a bike is pretty good, or a skateboard or a scooter. Just try to figure out some way, take yoga, take some tantric yoga, exotic yoga, aerobics, something to help Zumba, something to help facilitate your body to be actively involved here on the political process. So there's a lot more other facilities that we could be involved in, as well as due to COVID is also more of a virus, as well as it is an infectious disease. So it's pretty much be sure to.
I'm working on MVP.
To pretty much be sure to help you and your family.
Oh my gosh,
be pretty much be involved here on the check your whole body. So it is more of just an upper respiratory virus as well as a whole hemostatic virus system. So be sure to check your body's. Your whole system. So you want to check your upper respiratory tract, your upper respiratory bodies, as well as if you are, your whole body, if you are passing bowel movements correctly, if you have any issues with that, as well as to check your skin, if your skin is dry or if there's any problem with your skin. You know, it's pretty much a general body, as well as be sure to get a physical, have your annual physical check. Be sure you and your kids and your family are checked as well, and make sure that you are to asthma, exposure to upper bronchitis, bronchitis inflammation. If you have bronchitis inflammation, the COVID also might be an issue for you, as well as if you had asthma, as well as if you had anything with, if you are on cancer treatment, or if you're on dialysis, just be sure with any kind of oxygen treatment, be sure to check you and make sure you and your family are safe from COVID, as well as those of your family who are over 65 and those of your family who are under 5 years old. Be sure to keep your loved ones and your ones safe and without harm. You still want to make sure that the little babies are taken care of, as well as the older individuals. All right, so it is lovely here. It's a sunny day here, about 5:30 here in Milwaukee. Still got a lot more left to do. COVID, great communication with COVID, great. Make sure you and your family and your loved ones are informed about what's going on in the political process, as well as changes. Okay, I'm doing the 21 minutes, as well as pretty much getting out there in fall, June. Okay. Hi, how are you? August the 19th. So today is Wednesday, August the 19th. On August the 6th, 2 weeks ago, on JSOY, they said there were 3 cases of COVID-19 exposure detected at the Milwaukee Convention site. So again, even though there were 3 published cases before detected, right now, 2 weeks later, we still have to be sure that people are out. Of course, wearing face masks, as well as not letting yourself be exposed to any upper respiratory disease or anything like that. So please be sure to check your daily temperature check, as well as drink plenty of fluids, eat good, and be sure you are in a healthy and a happy environment with those around you, as well as where you're coming from and where you're going to. Now, Wisconsin Public Radio for PBS and NPR. Still a lot more people racing, hard driving racing is still going on, NASCAR is still going on, golf is still going on. So the Summerfest here in Milwaukee is still going on, with over 10,000 people here at the Summerfest Outdoor Festival here in Milwaukee. So that's going on as well as the DNC Convention Center. There's a lot of things going on, so I'm pretty much happy to be involved with that. Sure, keep you and your family tested and your loved ones safe and near. This is a clean bottle. I've got a lot to do every single day. You gotta give thanks for just a little bit of things, and you just keep involved with your own personal health, as well as the health of others around you. It's a beautiful day here in the city at 80, 85 degrees here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. On the Midwest, it's not the East Coast, not the West Coast, it's the Midwest. So I'm very happy to be here. Involved, trying to be involved on this global process, as well as those here and around me. Again, thank you to the DNC Milwaukee team, local DNC offices here in Milwaukee, as well as the DNC headquarters in Washington, D.C. Thank you to DNC leader Tom Perez and his staff, as well as the DNC staff. I'm going to go over them right quickly. The leadership team right quickly for the Democratic National Party. Chair of the Democratic National Party. We've got Tom Perez, who's a former U.S. Secretary of Labor, new President Barack H. Obama. We have the Karen Carter Peterson, Ms. Peterson, Boudica Woman. She's a Vice Chair of Civic Engagement and Voter Participation. We have Michael Blake of New York, Assemblyman Michael Blake, a wonderful young guy who's the Vice Chair of the Democratic National Party, as well as Treasurer William Bill DeWar, Secretary Jason Ray, and Finance Chair Chris Hortz II. Sylvia, thank you to the whole staff of the Democratic National Party located in Washington, D.C., which I know they are pretty much very, very, very busy right now. As well as to Maria Elena Durazo, Executive Secretary, Treasurer of the AFL-CIO, one of the great, great labor unions, as well as CEFCO. CEFCO is also a great union, and AFL-CIO is another great labor union, located everywhere, especially have a great team supporting all of them. So thank you to the labor union, AFL-CIO. Kate Martin, Chair of the Minnesota Democratic Farmer Labor Party. Grace Meg, Representative of New York City, Washington District, who is also Vice Chair of the Democratic Party. Jamie Harris, Associate Chair of the South Carolina Democratic Party. Maria Eleza DeRosso, Secretary Treasurer of the Labor Union, Vice Chair of the Democratic Party, and a lot of other people too. So thank you to the whole entire staff of the National Headquarters of the Democratic Party located in Washington, D.C. I still have a lot more to do that I'd be focused on, but again, I have to get out my stats and my papers and my numbers. This is LaQueen Battle coming live from the Democratic National Convention here at Milwaukee Airport and Democratic National Convention located at the Milwaukee Convention Center here in live and in Midwest, 6 hours outside of Chicago here at the convention site for the DNC 2020. Thank you so much, guys. Love you. Give me your thoughts and prayers. Thank you to the whole entire staff of the DNC 2020, as well as the National Headquarters, D.C., Chicago, Texas, Boston, New York, and our soon-to-be Vice President, California Senator Karen, Vice President, our future Vice President is...
taken in the airport with a woman with a black cab. They parked on the baggage drive in the crosswalk by door number 4 with template P022
Kamala Harris, California Senator Kamala Harris.
You know, one of the black cabs, they parked on the baggage drive
in
front of
my family
in
Los Angeles, California.
Shout out to
our future Vice President of the United States, Ms. Kamala Harris. So thank you so much here, guys. Give you a shout out to Joe Biden and the team of Joe Biden and his staff, as well as the team of Senator Kamala Harris and her staff. Thank you so much.